We are now starting our new series, and this new series is about the Hayat of the Barzakh. And of course, this is a precursor to Qiyamah and to the knowledge of heaven and hell. May Allah Azza wa Jal grant us Jannah and protect us from Jahannam. So we're working our way from the signs of Judgment Day until the actual Qiyamah, and then what will happen after Qiyamah. But there's going to be a few lectures that are in between. And that in between is called the life of the Barzakh. So in these series of lectures, we will discuss what do we know about the life of the Barzakh. And the term Barzakh is used in the Quran, and it is an Arabic word that implies a barrier, a middle. It implies something that is in between two things. And Allah Azza wa Jal uses the Barzakh in a physical and in a metaphysical sense. As for the physical, in Surah Ar-Rahman, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala says, مَرَجَ الْبَحْرَيْنِ يَلْتَقِيَانِ بَيْنَهُمَا بَرْزَخٌ لَا يَبْغِيَانِ. He has sent the two oceans or the two rivers flowing. Between these two rivers is what is a Barzakh. Now this Barzakh is a physical Barzakh. It's an actual barrier. So we get the word, what does Barzakh mean? Barzakh means an actual middle, something that separates the two. And by the way, the majority of our ulama understood Maraj al-Bahrin yaltaqiyan as being the Red Sea and the Persian Sea, or the Gulf if you like, and the Barzakh is the Arabian Peninsula. This is the majority interpretation of the scholars of the past. So it is as if Allah is saying, there's one ocean here, one ocean there. Between the two is the land of Hijaz, the land of Mecca and Medina. That is the Barzakh that these two oceans can never intermingle in. So this explains to us what is the Barzakh. The Barzakh is something in the middle that allows two things to be distinct. Those two things will not interact with one another because of the buffer in the middle. That buffer is called the Barzakh. With this physical Barzakh, let us get to the metaphysical Barzakh. What is the metaphysical Barzakh? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions Surah Al-Mu'minun verse 100. This is the only ayah in the whole Quran that mentions Barzakh in the metaphysical. The other Barzakh is the physical, that's a physical barrier. Two oceans, there's a Barzakh. The only ayah in the whole Quran that explicitly references Barzakh as a place between death and Qiyamah is Surah Al-Mu'minun verse 100. Allah Azza wa Jal mentions that after death, وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَخٌ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. In front of them is going to be a Barzakh until the day they are resurrected. This is the only ayah in the whole Quran that uses the term Barzakh the way that we're going to use it in this class, which is that interim, that buffer between this dunya and the next dunya. وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَخٌ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. In front of them, after their death, awaiting them, there shall be a Barzakh until the day that they are resurrected. Now, there might only be one explicit reference of Barzakh in the Quran, but there are many implied Quranic ayat about something after death and before resurrection. Okay? There are multiple ayat. How many? Scholars have differed because we're talking about indirect. 3, 5, some have said 7 even verses. And these are all indirect. So we'll discuss maybe 3 of them right now. There are verses in the Quran that clearly affirm something will happen after death and before Qiyamah. And this must be the Barzakh. What are some of these verses? We'll mention a number of them. Of them is Surah Tawbah, verse 101. Surah Tawbah, verse 101. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that, وَمِمَّنْ حَوْلَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَعْرَابِ مُنَافِقُونَ وَمِنْ أَهْلِ الْمَدِينَةِ. Around you, there are the Bedouins and the hypocrites, even though some of them are in Medina, some of them are the Bedouins, they are hypocrites. Allah says, سَنُعَذِّبُهُمْ مَرَّتَيْنِ ثُمَّ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَذَابٍ عَظِيمٍ. سَنُعَذِّبُهُمْ مَرَّتَيْنِ. We will punish them twice, and then we will send them to basically Jahannam. سَنُعَذِّبُهُمْ مَرَّتَيْنِ. Qatada said, one time in this dunya, the second time in the qabr, and then there will be Jahannam. Did you understand the indirect reference? سَنُعَذِّبُهُمْ مَرَّتَيْنِ ثُمَّ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَذَابٍ عَظِيمٍ. So we're going to punish them twice, then we will take them to Jahannam. What is the punishment twice? In this world, they will be humiliated. In this world, they will be discarded. In this world, they will go through the trials of this world. Then there's another punishment. When is this punishment that is before Jahannam? There must only be one time frame, and that is the Barzakh. So this is a reference indirectly. Indirectly because it's not explicit, but our scholars have derived the Barzakh from this. Also, another indirect reference, Surah At-Tur verse 47. Surah At-Tur verse 47, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the fire of Jahannam. He mentions in the context of sending people to Jahannam. And then he says, Surah At-Tur verse 47, وَإِنَّ لِلَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا عَذَابًا دُونَ ذَلِكَ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But those who have committed ظُلْم, and ظُلْم here means shirk, those who have worshipped other than Allah, they shall also be punished. Remember, the verse before is about Jahannam. Then Allah says, but that's not their only punishment. There shall be another punishment that is lesser than Jahannam. وَإِنَّ لِلَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا عَذَابًا دُونَ ذَلِكَ. They will also have a punishment that is lesser than Jahannam. What is lesser than Jahannam? It is the Barzakh. And Ibn Abbas said that he explicitly quoted this verse and he said, this is Adhabul Qabr. They will have Adhab Duna Thalik. Duna Thalik in Arabic means lesser than that. Ibn Abbas said, Duna Thalik is a reference to Adhabul Qabr. And so we have another indirect reference to something that will happen after death and before actual Qiyamah. And perhaps the most explicit of the indirect references, because there's a direct reference, that's Barzakh. The indirect references, there are many, but perhaps the most explicit is Surah Ghafir, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the father and son of the Fir'aun, right? All of you know that the Fir'aun that took care of Musa was not the same Fir'aun that then wanted to kill Musa, that was his son, right? As a father-son pair. So the Fir'aun that adopted Musa, then that Fir'aun dies, that Fir'aun's son comes to power, and then Musa becomes a prophet and is sent to that Fir'aun. So we have the father-son Fir'aun, the pair Fir'aun. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Ghafir, وَحَاقَ بِآلِ فِرْعَوْنَ سُوءَ الْعَذَابِ. The family of Fir'aun, meaning the father and son, they shall have a grave punishment. What is that punishment? Listen carefully. النَّارُ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا غُدُوًا وَعَشِيَّةً وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَدْخِلُوا آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ أَشَدَّ الْعَذَابِ. The fire of hell will be shown to them, being close to them, drawn close to them, morning and evening. النَّارُ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا. They will be roasted close by, but not directly. عَرَضَ means to show. عَرَضَ means to bring close to. So, يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا. They will be brought close to Jahannam, or Jahannam will be brought close to them, morning and evening. Then, when Qiyamah occurs, it will be said, enter the fire of hell and be punished the worst punishment. Do you see how explicit this is? Then, when Qiyamah takes place, وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَدْخِلُوا آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ. So what's happening before Qiyamah? They are not entering Jahannam. They're not inside Jahannam. What is happening? Jahannam is being shown to them. Jahannam is being brought close to them. النَّارُ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا غُدُوًا وَعَشِيَّةً. So Jahannam is being demonstrated to them morning and evening. Then when Qiyamah takes place, Allah will say, cause them to enter Jahannam. So what was happening before Qiyamah? The Barzakh and Adhabul Qabr. So we find here multiple evidences from the Quran that there's something after death and before Qiyamah, and this is the time frame known as the Barzakh. The Barzakh begins from the moment the ruh permanently leaves the body, and it ends at the last trumpet to be blown. This is the Barzakh. Okay? So the Barzakh begins when the ruh leaves the body permanently. And the Barzakh ends when the last trumpet is blown and all of the souls are resurrected. Now, the Barzakh in this dunya, you might think that some people's Barzakh is longer than others. But the Barzakh is beyond our time and our space. So if somebody died 10,000 years ago, and somebody dies after 1,000, 2,000 years, how many years we have left, Allah knows, their barzakh is not necessarily different or more or longer. Because time in the barzakh is not the same as time in this dunya. So time for them is something completely different. And we will get to this point. For the believer, the barzakh will be a place of quick ease. They will zoom through it, a place of peace. And for other than them, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, the barzakh will seem to last an eternity. Even if maybe they were of the last generations, they will think they were in an eternity. So the time of the barzakh is irrelevant from our dunya. It is a separate time frame. It has nothing to do with us.